Hi, this is Simon from HomeKit News, and this week we're taking a look at possibly the brightest HomeKit-enabled light I've reviewed so far, the Mi Smart LED Ceiling Light 450. It may have the lumens, but is it a worthy light? Let's have a look. So starting off with unboxing this rather large carton, and you can see that it's by Mijia or Xiaomi, along with a long unimaginative name, along with the 450 designation referring to its size. As with most Mi products, it works with Google, Amazon and of course HomeKit. The front of the box gives all of its features away up front, literally, with adjustable colour temperature and brightness, and boasts a high colour rendering index, which I believe means accurate colour temperature. It works with 100 to 240 volts, and it can be controlled remotely or via voice control, of course, and it's both dust and moth proof, so no insects should get stuck in the fittings. You'll also notice that its name is in Russian as well, as this is available there, although it may be available in other parts of Europe soon. Some of the additional features mentioned on the box include a daylight and moonlight mode, the latter of which allows the light's LEDs to go to super low brightness levels, and due to the high brightness you can achieve, which we'll get into a bit, you should easily be able to cover rooms up to 25 square meters. Here are the detailed specs, so feel free to pause the video for this, but some of the basics are that it's a 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi device. It also includes a Bluetooth gateway for Xiaomi Bluetooth devices, and it can reach up to 3100 lumens in brightness. There's not a lot in the box, so aside from the lamp itself, you just get some screws and roll plugs to fit the light to the ceiling, as well as a manual in multiple languages, which also has one of two instances of the HomeKit code. The light basically comes in two sections, the first of which is the large down-facing diffuser. This clips onto the main part of the light with sliding catches that are secured when you turn the diffuser, much like the lid of a jam jar, for example. It's quite lightweight and basic, but it doesn't feel cheap or flimsy. Now let's have a quick look at the part that contains the electronics and the LEDs. So if we have a quick look, we can see the middle section that houses the transformer, which also includes the second instance of the HomeKit code, and is surrounded with a generous amount of LEDs. Now these LEDs can produce both warm and cool whites, as well as the super low level moonlight mode that I mentioned earlier. In the center, you also see the connector for the live, neutral and earth wires for when you want to replace your old light fitting. Here you can see the corresponding fasteners that connect to the clips inside the diffuser to secure the two parts and to keep it in place. You simply turn it until it's fastened tightly, all very simple. Of course, you do need to secure it to the ceiling before you put the lid on, but so far so good, and it feels really well made and solidly put together. So let's move on to installation. Now I recommend adding it to Mi Home first to access the extras not exposed to HomeKit, like the moonlight mode for example. And as it uses Bluetooth for setup, your phone should automatically detect it. You then have to turn it on and off 7 times to reset the light before adding it to your Wi-Fi network. Now in this instance I've already gone through the reset process, so I just need to add it to my 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, whereby it'll begin connecting and eventually be added to Mi Home, where you choose which room to place it. Unfortunately, as is the case with pretty much all products you can add to Mi Home and HomeKit, it doesn't carry the name and room information over to HomeKit, so you'll have to do this separately again, unless of course you only use Mi Home. So once added to a room and appropriately named, I then get the option to add it to HomeKit in the normal way, where you'll scan the HomeKit code as standard. So even though this is the Mi Home app, you'll recognize the familiar interface for scanning the HomeKit code. And whilst you get to add it to a room in HomeKit as well as name it, you are still in the Mi Home app. So if you want to change things like the icon, for example, you'll have to do it once this initial procedure is complete, as essentially, like I say, you're still in the Mi Home app. After that's all done, you'll continue in the Mi Home app, and the first screen you see in this case is for controlling the colour, temperature and brightness, where you simply slide your finger left and right or up and down to control these respective aspects. As you can see on the main screen, you can see that it's added as a new device. Now if we switch over to the Home app, you'll see that it's already waiting for us there too. Now, as expected, we can control the on-off functionality of the light, but if we long press on the tile, you'll see that we have the basic control of the brightness and the color temperature as before. Now, if you have the Yeelight app and are signed in using the same details as the Mi Home app, it will automatically show up there too, where you can take advantage of moonlight mode as well as a few presets. So as demonstrated here, I can control the colour temperature, starting off in mid-white before moving over to cool white. You can make out the light blue tint in this instance. Now if I move the marker over to the other end, you can see the light going to warm white with a very obvious orange tint to the LEDs. From this same screen, I can also control the brightness using the slider at the bottom, allowing me brightness of anywhere between 100 and 1%, although in reality 10% seems to be the minimum. However, if you select the moon mode, you can see that the light can go extra low in terms of brightness, which is especially useful for nighttime trips to the bathroom, for example, or perhaps a child's room if they're scared of the dark and want just enough light to make them feel safe. Now, even though it may not be so obvious from the footage here, you can get to extremely low levels of brightness, with even 1% increments in brightness being just about discernible. There are a few lighting presets, including sunrise and sunset, to gradually raise or lower the brightness of the light over a period of time, as well as presets for reading or relaxing. But as this is not a colour lamp, your options are a little bit more limited. Still, some of these presets can be quite useful in certain instances, like the flash notify preset, which you can use to let you know when someone has opened a door, for example, if said door has a door sensor connected to it. Now, some of these are mere novelties, however, like the candle flicker preset, for example. But it's still nice to have these options, and with Siri shortcuts, they are accessible, just not via HomeKit, unfortunately. Now, speaking of control, let's move over to some optional extras. What's also great is that you can also control the light in a couple of other more hands-on ways. Now, even though this is Mi branded, it's made by Yeelight, and so you can pair the Yeelight remote with this if you wish, which uses Bluetooth to communicate directly with the light itself. Now, the remote doesn't appear in any of the apps as a device, however, but with this remote you can turn it on and off, control the brightness, change the colour temperature, and even switch to moon mode if you want. As this is designed as a remote control rather than a wireless switch, it doesn't come with any mounting options, although there's nothing to stop you from doing so if you so wish. Now, the Yeelight remote uses a standard CR2032 battery, so you should get at least 12 months use out of it. Next, we have another Yeelight control, this time a rotary dimmer switch. As with the remote, this uses Bluetooth, but it's more of a standard looking wall switch with a central dial that also acts as a push button switch. Now, the switch has single, double and long press actions, as well as the ability to control the brightness and colour temperature with the rotary dial, which I'll demonstrate shortly. Now, the switch also has separate adhesive strips for the wall and the switch that hold to each other with Velcro. There's also a reset button at the top of the switch. So first of all, back to the remote, and you can see that I can turn it on and off with the individual buttons. I can also increase or decrease the brightness levels using the brightness rocker button if I so wish, and if I select the colour temperature button, I can gradually change the colour temperature by pressing and or holding until I get the desired temperature. And finally, with the mode button, I can switch between standard or sun mode and moon mode, which can also be adjusted for brightness but not temperature. Onto the rotary dial, and simply pressing the dial turns the light on and off as expected. Now, when the light is on and I turn the dial, that simply controls the brightness levels. If I press and hold the dial whilst also turning it, I can adjust the colour temperature. If I then double click on the dial, I can switch between sun or normal mode and moon mode. Now, you probably can't see a lot of difference right now, but if I lower the brightness whilst in moon mode, you can just about make out that it's actually on, but at a very low level of brightness. So finally, onto the pros and cons. And after purchasing this lamp in Taiwan quite a few months ago now, I've been pretty happy with it, and I can say it really does an excellent job of brightening a decent sized room without any issues due to its 3100 lumen output. Now, if you take the price I paid, which was roughly equivalent to $64, €53 or £47, compared to the amount of bulbs you'd need to achieve the same kind of brightness, then it's pretty good value for money. The design is simple and it doesn't draw attention to itself, which I really like. And if you have any Bluetooth devices in Mi Home, then the built-in gateway will allow them to connect to Wi-Fi so you can access them remotely, which is really handy. The moonlight mode is really handy as well for when you want to some light but you don't want to wake somebody up, and it can also be controlled by Siri shortcuts, for example. The inexpensive but useful remote or rotary dial, both of which are optional extras, bring this closer to something like a normal light for those that don't want to use their phone, so that's kind of a good option. Having it work with Mi Home, Yeelight and HomeKit has a lot of functional possibilities to control other non-HomeKit devices via automation, so that's another plus. Now, the only downside is that the Moonlight mode isn't accessible in HomeKit, but as already mentioned, you can still control it via Siri shortcuts and Siri on your HomePod or HomePod Mini if needed. So that's it for now, but do head over to HomeKit News for the full in-depth review if that's something you prefer. Thanks for dropping by, and we'll see you in the next one.